Rootstocks are used for grafting when a fruit type doesn't grow well in their own roots. That's why most fruit varieties are grafted to a specific rootstock instead of being planted directly in the soil. Different rootstocks have different characteristics. They can be resistant to diseases, to drought or to wet soils, and they will usually produce a smaller and more productive tree. Nevertheless, they can be difficult to obtain and expensive, so it's only natural that we try to propagate our own. If for some reason you have to cut a tree that was grafted into a rootstock of interest, don't remove the stump and root system. After a few months, several suckers will grow near the old stump. These suckers are developing from the old rootstock and will have identical characteristics. Now, it's only a matter of freeing the suckers with a few roots to obtain new rootstocks. So, the next time you have a failed bark graft when top working a tree, instead of regrafting, consider leaving the stump to obtain new rootstocks if you need them. Avoid leaving several branches in the collected rootstocks. If you have to use a saw to free them from the main root system, try to leave clean cuts and remove any broken roots. These young rootstocks will be much easier to graft, and you can use several different techniques. Be sure to check my grafting videos to learn different grafting techniques that you can use in every situation. You can also do this process deliberately with a cheap store-bought tree that comes grafted into a rootstock of the desired type. When doing this process deliberately, there are some refinements you can do to have better root development and produce rootstocks of the same size. You can also try to root a few natural suckers that grow from your rootstocks when you prune them. These techniques will be covered in a future video. Thanks for watching. If you like my videos, subscribe, share and leave a comment to help me make more. Click the bell to receive notifications of new videos.